So you asked me to ask you a question.
Yeah.
No, but it makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
So basically, with all this move to JavaScript, front-end, SPAs, all that, okay? What about accessibility? What about, you know, like these apps, how can they care about accessibility? And what are the things that we should be careful about when we do SPAs?
Right. Yeah. So the answer to this is kind of, there might be multiple answers, like anything. But I think, I'll speak from my own experience, the apps that I started to write once I went into the SPA rabbit hole became less accessible. Definitely less accessible. Like, you can't get a more accessible app than one written in HTML and CSS with only HTML, semantic HTML. That's like accessible out of the box. So in my reflections on why my apps were more inaccessible, I think the point blank answer is because I got front end superpowers and I could just write anything I wanted myself. If I wanted a taggable input element, I'll just write it. If I want, I'm doing all this stuff myself, I'm not making sure that I have ARIA labels on it. Where if you wanted a modal in Bootstrap, did you ever program in Bootstrap?
Not so much.
Not so much? Okay. Anybody watching,
everyone knows Bootstrap,
who's a Bootstrapper is going to get this. You need a modal in Bootstrap. And you go, oh, I don't remember. You know the panel class and everything, but what's the modal markup? You Google it. You get to the Bootstrap docs. Mm-hmm. You see the big modal markup. You copy and paste it. And it looks gross. You're like, oh, there's so much, but whatever. I'm using Bootstrap to do it. All that grossness is ARIA labels, like ARIA roles and all that stuff. So modals were accessible, and there's all those accessibility rules. Now in Vue.js, when I need a modal, I make a modal.view component that has a div with a vif for a state called show, and that's it. And maybe I CSS an overlay in the background, but there's like very specific things. Like accessibility-wise, in a modal, you need the focus to loop back to the top so the user, right? All these things that I would never, like, who has the time to worry about that? So I think just in general, this move to SPAs, because we're writing everything ourselves because we have these superpowers now, think in general, apps are less accessible from your average, like, normal developer who doesn't have the time to become an accessibility expert.
But don't you think, so here, for instance, maybe I will ask you the question afterwards.
Yeah.
But maybe just a little clarification of what do we mean here by accessibility.
I guess most people understand
it, but let's just, can you tell us
some
examples?
What I mean by accessibility is making your, the broad answer is making your app usable to all. Mm-hmm. Is a good way to kind of bring it back to the intent for me. But in reality, it's like, is your app usable for screen readers? I mean, there's a lot of other things that goes into it, and I'm not an expert, but if somebody's using a screen reader and they're using your app and you have an amount slider for some dollar amount, they don't have a mouse. Like, they have a screen reader. And can they get to that? Can their screen reader know how to get to that? So my little accessibility, I'll say, I don't know the right word, my quick little test is just, can you tab to your component and change and do what you need to do with your keyboard? If you can do that, it's probably pretty accessible. At least it's a baseline of accessible.
Because the other way around, it could be like displayed well on the interface, but the order of the DOM elements is not right, and you can't reach to that in order.
Sure. And maybe the tags are wonky and the labels are wonky, or you're doing some weird custom JavaScript stuff. And
I guess on Friday, I was talking with someone we were working, and she told me, like, front end, which is working on HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, little JavaScript for behavior, but not the component frameworks.
Yeah,
she told me like this is a full time job just to get the browsers and accessibility right. It's a full time job without even touching to any logic.
It's so true. It's and the more I wade into this world, the more I go, oh my gosh, there's so much to know. There's so much to know, and add this on to, especially if you're a full stack developer, like. It's insane. And yeah, exactly. Yeah.
And it's not only for like screen readers, even if like I don't want to, it's very important, right? But also if your HTML behaves well, semantic, and all that, you can profit from native device representation of these kind of things, right?
Yeah.
Of your elements, right?
That is my biggest prescription for to make your apps more accessible, whether it's an SPA or not. I think the SPA context sort of the non-SPA context encourages native tooling, native, and the SPA context encourages non-native tooling, but it's not a, it's just a symptom of being in a more advanced architecture that you can just pull in. A good example is drop zone. If you want to do file uploads, like you could use input type file, and that would be the native browser supported file upload, and that's accessible and it works and it's there, but it feels old or it feels yucky. So you mm-hmm. might code your own thing in JavaScript or pull in one of these packages. You don't know if it's accessible. So my biggest tip to anybody with accessibility is like, write things more simply, more semantically. And if you can afford the native browser offerings, use them because they're accessible by default, you know.
And maybe just feel for the other browsers that don't have that native behavior for that file field or anything like that, right?
Sure. You're saying in the case of something custom or something.
No, if you use that native thing,
right,
and it behaves very well on some devices, one yeah. on the others, you can just write code to make them
true. Yeah, behave but in better. General, the native stuff. You're right. Some doesn't, but the native stuff I think works more cross browser compatible. Absolutely. than you know.
But nothing is worse than being on your iPhone and having a drop down list where you click on it, it actually opens in the page, and now you have to pinch and zoom and find it and scroll that list.
Right.
Whereas you have a native thing in an iPhone where
and it doesn't like gravity scroll.
No, yeah.
So you scroll and it just stops.
It sticks to your finger.
Or you click on it and it's a select and there's a drop down, but it opens your keyboard, but it doesn't know that the keyboard's open, so the lists are under the keyboard. Then you spend 2 days Googling how to detect if a keyboard is shown in JavaScript.
Or you kind of try to.
Or yeah. That. So oh man, I mean that's just. That's a select input. But so the reason I know so much about this is because I spent years making horribly inaccessible view apps with view select that's actually inaccessible. Maybe it is now, but it wasn't accessible for the longest time. And that's the default answer. If you're in view and you want a select element, you use view select. And it wasn't accessible. I went to ViewConf and I forget his name, but he did an accessibility talk and he had a blind person next to him trying to use his view app and couldn't use view select. And I was like, what are we doing? What am I doing?
So that's view select.
View select. I think it's got to be fixed now.
Maybe fixed.
Enough people probably. View select, view talk. Hyphen select, yeah.
But we talked about, you know, SPAs, and we thought like, oh, because they have that power. But isn't it also powerful if people implement components in an accessible way, then everyone will profit from that for free?
Exactly. Huge, yeah. Yeah, and so that's why I'm careful to say that it's not by virtue of being an SPA that accessible. No, it's just the way that things have happened. It's happened this way, but like you said, there's huge potential for big robust components to be open source maintained and the community to keep working on them, making them more accessible and more robust, and then we all benefit from them. So it's kind of the same thing where now I'm using Vue. Now I'm going to just vouch for Vue Select and say that this is the case. You pull in Vue Select, you have an accessible. You know, right?
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Yeah.